Thank you. Thank you. Well, good morning, everyone. On behalf of the trustees, the administration, the faculty, the entire Glen Oak Country School community, it is my pleasure to welcome parents, family and friends, faculty, students, and alumni to the 33rd Upper School Commencement of Glen Oak Country School, celebrating the achievement of the class of 2021. 74 members of the class, a talented, diverse, and unique and memorable group of dragons who have shown incredible resilience and fortitude in dealing with the unprecedented times we are all experiencing. They are about to take the next step in their lives, and we are proud of them on their special day. Who could have conceived of the challenges and hurdles that we have experienced and we have all had to face over this last year? These seniors have become pioneers in virtual learning, in shifting priorities, in tempering expectations, rolling with the punches while setting new traditions. Their achievements in the face of adversity are indeed admirable. Our respect for you is as high as it can be. And like you and all of us, I am so glad we could be together this morning. This is a celebratory occasion for so many in the GCS family. For our faculty, it is an opportunity for us to acknowledge and publicly recognize their role in this journey of the class of 2021. I congratulate my colleagues on the faculty and staff for a job well done. I thank you for your commitment to our students. It is a privilege to have worked with you. I salute the extraordinary efforts you have made over these pandemic months. Thank you, faculty. It can be both exceptionally gratifying and very challenging to work at the school your children attend, and so many of our faculty and staff members have that experience. I congratulate the Vallejo family as Sophia graduates today, and we wish you all the best. Thanks, Sophia, and Emily, and the family. Five of today's graduates are the children of GCS trustees. Our board does so much to ensure the success of our school, and we appreciate their efforts. Thank you and congratulations to the Singh family as Noor and Imrose graduate, the Moynihan family as Stella graduates, the Morningstar family as Catherine graduates, and the Resch family as Trixie graduates. Congratulations. I also want to thank and congratulate our longtime PNFA president, Francine Hopkins, as her grandson, Jacob Luna, graduates. Congratulations, Francine. Thanks to the seniors and their parents who supported the wonderful senior gift this year, the continuation of the Dragon Commons with the expansion of the patio and the addition of wonderful patio furniture. The Adirondack chairs have been especially popular with the faculty. Thanks for your generous support. Before we move ahead, I must remind us all of how much our founders, Mr. Kingdon Gould Jr. and Mary Thorne Gould, truly loved attending commencements. They were always so full of pride at the accomplishments of our seniors. They reveled in speaking with them about their GCS experiences and hearing about their plans. We miss them, and we know they would be proud to celebrate the outstanding achievements of this great class. First, we would like to recognize our students who have never attended another school and have spent at least 13 consecutive years at GCS. This year we have 23, a record number of lifers. They have literally always been dragons. Please welcome to the stage former lower school head Linda Rotter and outgoing lower school head Ann Woolihand, who will present the Always a Dragon plaques to our lifers. Welcome back, Linda. John Adams. Isabella Ardia. Ariane Asimani. Ryan Clemens. Daniel Hersey. They can sort it out. They know who they are. Jacob Hopkins Luna. Aaron Jacobs. Anna Lucas. Brian Teske. I got you, Connor, don't worry. Connor Malone. Congratulations. Thomas Berbert. Dylan George. Brianna Hibbert. Damon Kathoria. Catherine Morningstar. Stella Moynihan. Esther Nissen. Ryan Russo. AJ Singh. Imros Singh. Noor Singh. Sophia Vallejo. And Kristen Verma. Congratulations, you guys. Thank you, Linda. There are a few students who have left GCS and returned. They are called lost and founds. and there were three laughs in this class. So Seth Miller, Mitchell Turner, and Juliet Yote, we are so happy you found your way back to us. Congratulations. The families of this class have also been especially loyal and committed to GCS. 21 seniors have had GCS graduates precede them, and many have younger siblings yet to graduate. So senior families, thank you for your continued support over so many years. Now we will hear from our student speakers. The first speaker is Aaron Jacobs.
Thank you, Mr. Ventry. I will say my biggest fear when giving a graduation speech was that I was going to trip walking from the chair to the podium. So I'm 2 for 2, feeling really good. Good morning, everybody. I have attended quite a few graduations, and I completely understand that feeling of dread as someone walks up to this mic and begins to go on and on about new chapters and experiences in life and all that stereotypical graduation crap. So to begin, here are the three things Wikipedia says I need to put in a graduation speech. I'm just kidding, I know the entire GCS Humanities Department would give me a very disappointing look if I actually cited Wikipedia in a graduation speech. Let me start with something simple. Class of 2021, we did it. I know there were days when June 2021 felt like it would never come. Like when we first received our password to play on the school computers, and Mrs. Dodge told us to type in Dragons 21. I remember asking what the 21 meant, and was told it was the year we graduated. Man, 2021, it was so far away. Fast forward to lower school. Our grade was getting lectured from Miss Woollyhand about why our behavior at the Goddard Space Center was unacceptable. Apparently, climbing on million-dollar spacecrafts, not a good look for the school. Now, she said the class of 2021 needed to grow up, but man, 2021 was so far away. Even last year, entering a pandemic, all of us struggling to somehow complete physics problems and memorize some Moby Dick passage about a pasteboard mask, 2020 felt like it would never end. And man, 2021 was so far away. But at last, here we are, here it is. As I think about my time here coming to a close, I find myself reminiscing about the small details of my daily life over these past 14 years. That's a really long time. Weirdly enough, I've become increasingly fascinated with my drive into school every morning. For 14 years, I've taken the same roads and stopped at the same lights. But I believe there's a lot to learn from the drive. A lot has changed. I can drive on my own to school, which is a considerable upgrade to sitting in the back seat while my dad drove me to primary school, my brother to middle school, all while ESPN radio hosts rambled on in the background and Christopher was memorizing a Barlow poem. The speed limit on Folly Quarter went from 45 to 35, and judging by the speed some of the teachers I follow to school drive on that road, I see you also don't support that change. Indeed, a lot has changed. But I would argue the best realization is noticing the consistencies. Bikers always bike on Folly Quarter at the worst possible time, providing a great bonding moment for every poor soul caught behind them. Mr. Ventry's house has stood as a welcoming landmark in the wee hours of the morning as I arrived. And even as my feelings from making that turn into school have fluctuated, from excitement to nervousness to exhaustion, that house has stood as a pillar for consistency and a reminder that it and everything else would be there the next day. On that drive, I always knew I'd be greeted by teachers that cared, even when my classmates and I would definitely push some buttons. That always rang true no matter which division was my destination. Class of 2021, my point here is this. Things have changed here in our time at Glen Elg. People have left, we have grown, our lives have grown way more complicated. But I encourage you to look at those little moments that have remained the same. Being grateful for past consistencies in life often helps us all become more willing to take a leap of faith and to change. Now, this wouldn't be a graduation speech without a few thank yous. That was in the Wikipedia article. To Mrs. Prano, Mrs. Willie Hand, and Mr. Ventry. There you are. Like us, your time here is coming to a close, and I could give an entire speech dedicated to each of your sacrifices to better the school and its community, but I don't think words do it justice. So sincerely, I just want to say thank you. For me, this class, these families, and anyone else you have made a long-term impact on, I hope you each enjoy some lovely and much-deserved time away. Let's give those three a giant round of applause. They've earned it. To my teachers, all the way in the back, I still see you. I'm sorry I made a couple of you cry. And a few of you actively lose your patience telling me to quiet down one too many times. I promise you, it was all out of love. And now I am graduating and just want to express my gratitude for each and every one of you. The lessons you have taught me, both in and out of the classroom, have made me the person I am today. And I hope you understand that your impact on me and the rest of my classmates will remain with each and every one of us forever. To the parents, a piece of you is also graduating today. For some of you, you've gone through this before. For those who haven't, I encourage you not to stress. From personal experience, some of you may be worried about your child moving on into new chapters. It's understandable, but your presence is always with them. For my brother, he always thought of my mom in the late hours of the night when he was lost in a grocery store, calling to ask what aisle pasta is in. So I promise, even though you think we are old, some things never change. And your sacrifices to help us all walk on this stage are deeply appreciated, even if we all have some pretty funny ways of showing it. So congratulations to you as well for successfully raising a high schooler. Lastly, to my classmates and friends, thank you. Thank you for the daily laughs, the crying sessions, and the moments of joy. You are all my family, and I am so beyond proud of us for making it here today. We have bonded together, held strong, and come out of these past years stronger as a group and as individuals. Please give yourself a round of applause and a pat on the back for this accomplishment. We will all now go our separate ways, but I ask you to cherish our moments together, as I know I forever will. So this is it. Man, June 2021 is here, and we graduate today. As we all took our diplomas in a few minutes, I ask everyone to keep a few things in mind. One, be grateful for the people who have gotten you this far. Two, remember the little moments that have made the journey that much better. Three, be thankful for the consistency we have had here in our time at GCS. Four, go Army, beat Navy. And finally, may God look over you if you ever get stuck behind a biker on Folly Quarter Road. Thank you, and once again, congratulations to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Aaron. Next to speak, Nawab Mahmood.
Wow, this is a lot of people. Like Aaron said, I will be addressing the typical graduation crap. Welcome, families, friends, faculty, and the graduating class of 2021. Thank you and congratulations to all of us. With the crazy year that has passed, what a tremendous honor it is to be here in the same place as one another. But last year, on Thursday, March 12th, 2020, it was different. It was the last regular school day for all of us. GCS was getting ready to go on spring break a day early in wake of the new COVID-19 virus that had just entered the States. Many of us were so excited at the time, thinking about a potential 2, maybe even 3 week long spring break. Teachers put in their predictions, some saying we'd be back in school after only a week, and others going to the extreme, saying we won't be back till near the end of May. But in reality, no one could have predicted what was in store for us. And nobody had any idea just how much this pandemic would affect us and soon take from us. We've had to persevere through so many different struggles this year, but we've grown so much, being the first ever official graduating virtual class. Starting the school year, not seeing any of the new students or our old classmates really made it difficult for our class to connect with each other. Taking on the college admissions process without being able to take the SATs or the ACTs, and having to apply fully digitally without being able to visit any campuses, presented many more obstacles on our road to graduate. But even during these darkest moments of this unprecedented journey, there was still light. The time we spent apart from our school, our friends, and our teachers, we spent it with our families. In the chaos that is being a student almost off to college for the next 4 years, many of us moving to new cities, hours away from home, the greatest gift was the time we spent at home with the ones who matter most. It is important to remind ourselves that the time we spent apart was not time entirely lost. We were still learning, still growing, and still becoming the next generation of teachers, lawyers, entrepreneurs, physicians, pilots, astronauts, engineers, and artists. And our hardships have made us the strongest and most dedicated and most persistent class to ever graduate. And today, no matter what paths we've laid out in front of us, no matter where our expectations and imaginations will inevitably take us, I'd like to offer us all one collective dream, one collective thing to work for in this life, one collective objective, and that is radical joy. Radical joy is the unapologetic choice to seek delight, show gratitude, and prioritize your dreams in the midst of even the most chaotic of times. That feeling you get laughing uncontrollably with your friends at the lunch table until you can barely breathe. The feeling of playing in the championship soccer game in overtime and hitting the game-winning goal while your teammates run onto the field tackling you. I'm sure you know how that feels, Mitchell. Or the feeling we all had 2 weeks ago in the senior parade, driving through campus, seeing all the teachers and students from pre-K through 12th, cheering us on as we say farewell to this great, beautiful journey. And the last 4 years have been made up entirely of moments not promised or expected, but rather unpredictable and full of surprises. And in the same way, my dream for us is this, that no matter what we strive for in this life, may we always strive for radical joy on our way there. And I wish that upon each of us. And today, perhaps more than anything else we feel, and more than we will ever be able to put into words, I know that I speak for the entire class of 2021 when I say we feel radical joy. We are thankful for Glen Oak Country School, a place that is more than just a building. It is a home that brought us a family. A family we know we can always come back home to. We are grateful for our faculty and educators because they didn't just teach us. They nurtured us, they grew us, they inspired us, and they made us better than they found us. Two people whom I'm especially grateful for today are Mr. Ventry and Ms. Prantl. They've been there for us through all our ups and downs, have always had our backs in the toughest of moments, and we are honored to be their last official graduating class. We wish you both, and the rest of the faculty that won't be returning next year as well, a happy next chapter in your lives ahead, and hope you as well continue to prioritize radical joy. We are also abundantly grateful for our families, the people who pushed for us to be here. As your children, we know we are products of great sacrifice. And while our families are all here celebrating our accomplishments today, we celebrate our families today too. And now, of course, perhaps most of all, the students. I know that each student in this arena is thankful for each and every one of their classmates. Thank you for making this the time of our lives. I hope you'll cherish the endless memories we created together. And good luck to each of us as we chase our next dream. Glen Oak Country School, class of 2021, congratulations. Let the future be bright because the best is still yet to come.
Wonderful, Nawab. I'll work on the radical joy concept. It was new, but it really sounds good, doesn't it? Right? It's my pleasure now to introduce the father of two GCS graduates, the chairman of our Board of Trustees, Mr. Bradley Smith.
Excellent job by Aaron and Nawab. Thank you. Good morning, Dragons. I'm Brad Smith, chair of the GCS Board of Trustees. On behalf of the board, I would like to thank you for joining us this beautiful morning. Is it beautiful, Greg?
It's beautiful.
It's a beautiful morning. To what is the culmination and celebration of many, many years of hard work by the class of 2021. As Greg said, I'm the parent of two graduates of GCS in 2012 and 2014, so today I can relate to both the pride and nostalgia felt by the parents and loved ones in our audience and congratulate them on having raised such impressive young adults. Are we good? Better? Okay. This has been an interesting year, senior year for the class of 2021. Your class has experienced changes to our normal GCS practices and schedule that no one could have expected or considered a little over a year ago. Your class has led the way for the rest of the school to embrace these changes and ensure education and learning continued. I know you were very disappointed in many events that did not occur in their normal or historic way, whether that be theater performance in front of a packed mullets versus in the woods with limited family members, athletic events with masks, or not having your integrative defenses in front of a supportive forum, to name a few. However, you did not complain, and you just made the best of the cards dealt to this class and proceeded to wrapping up a very successful senior year at GCS and 13 plus years for those 23 lifers in this class, which, as Greg mentioned, is a record number. You will discover disappointments in every turn of your life. How you handle luck, good or bad, and those disappointments will determine your long-term successes, and by judging your recent actions, this class will be just fine going forward. Their resiliency is to be commended. To our graduates, I hope that you appreciate the value of your educational experience at GCS. We know it wasn't always easy. We understand that sacrifices were made by many of you and your families in order for you to attend GCS, but you are the best evidence that such sacrifices were worth it. The GCS bubble went on graduation day, but reviewing all the wonderful college choices that you have been accepted at and will be attending, I believe that you are more than ready. We have watched your class develop athletically, artistically, and academically over the past 13 years. You have accomplished a tremendous amount that you and your parents and family should be very proud of, as is the board, the leadership team, your teachers, and advisors are. You are soon to be the next ambassadors from GCS. Your successes forward will reflect positively on GCS, and your experiences here have prepared you for those successes. Please remember GCS and return as proud alumni to further the legacy of GCS by participating in as many events that you can to stay connected. We certainly will remember you. We will remember you as the class that rose to and overcome the many challenges faced by GCS during the present year. As I said when I began, it's been an interesting year for both GCS and your class. You showed maturity, resiliency, and leadership beyond your years. By doing so, you lived the words of our mission statement and helped us all move forward. You were the last graduating class under Mr. Ventry's leadership and guidance. There have been 13 other graduating classes, but many of you, including the lifers, started about the same time as he started as our head of school. For that, your class will always have a special place in his memories and ours. Thank you, and we wish you much happiness and success in the years to come. The class of 2021 will now receive their diplomas.
One of the things I've had to put up with being vertically challenged over the last 14 years is extremely tall board chairs. I'm referring to you, Rob, and also even Ty was taller than me, but most people are. In special circumstances, we award honorary diplomas to faculty members who have served the school with particular distinction for at least 20 years. This year, I have the privilege of awarding two. The first to Paul Weir. 23 years at GCS, our outgoing athletic director began as an athletic trainer. Paul has been our AD since 2015. He's overseen the rise of the GCS athletic program as it reached new levels of success and recognition while maintaining the highest standards of sportsmanship. Paul's two daughters, Amelia and Amanda, are GCS graduates. You may know his wife, Debbie, painted the mural in our conference room. Congratulations and thank you, Paul.
Thank you, sir. Yep.
Ann Woollyhand. We recognize Ann's 23 years at GCS, which actually began before she was out of college. Her accomplishments are too many to recount here, but I think she would want us to mention our involvement with the Marshall Legacy Institute and Children Against Mines, Kid Lead, the Fish Philosophy, the courage and vision the lower school has shown and being on campus and open for the whole year. Ann is the mom of two GCS lifers, Bridget and Jessica, who just a few weeks ago received her DVM degree. Congratulations and thank you, Ann. Seniors, your names are already inscribed on our alumni wall. I know some of you saw that. Folks, you should take a look at that after the ceremony. Now, as we prepare to award diplomas, please refer to your programs as we move through the class. It's filled with the achievements of our seniors, mentions their plans for the future, and gives you a sense of how much they have accomplished. Of course, I issue my annual disclaimer. The comments that I'm going to read about them are what they wanted me to read. I didn't make them up. So parents, note that what I read comes from your children. With just a little bit of editing from me, it may not be what you expect to hear, but it is what they wanted me to say. John Marat Adams. John says, "The school makes it so easy to meet people and make tons of friends. The first day of high school as a freshman can feel overwhelming, and the school made me feel easy and safe, comfortable and confident, whether you are introverted or extroverted. I will never forget the welcoming feeling from the upperclassmen and the faculty when I first went into the upper school. It's an experience you just can't recreate." Jono's quote is, "You never learn to appreciate what you have until it's too late. Make the most of what you have so you have no regrets when it's gone." Congratulations, Jono. Isabella Malia Ardia. An important experience of mine at GCS was definitely meeting all the amazing people and teachers who were always there to assist me whenever it was needed. A few important things are, I'm a GCS lifer, and I'm very excited to graduate. And Isabella's new quote, which we just got this morning, take pride in how you've come here. Have faith in how far you can go. But don't forget to enjoy the journey. Congratulations, Bella. Moyo James Ario. My best experience at GCS came from having the privilege of being a part of the soccer team. Having humid 8 a.m. practices in August with my teammates is something I missed a lot when we weren't able to do it anymore. The two seasons we had with Coach Steitler gave the guys and I some of the funniest memories on the field. Bruiser.
Bruiser!
The quote from Steve Jobs, "Remembering that you are going to die is the best way I know to avoid the trap of thinking you have something to lose." Congratulations, Moyo.
Buddy, congratulations.
Marcus Everett Arteburn. Marcus says, "I recommend Glen Elk Country to anyone looking for a quality education. I wish the class of 2021 the best in their future plans. I'd like to thank my parents and family for supporting me through the thick and thin, and always supporting every dumb decision I made in the last 4 years. I'd like to thank all my teachers who have dealt with my lack of organization and untimely turning in of assignments." But Marcus's quote is, "Get her done." Congratulations, Marcus.
Ready? Good job. Congratulations. Good job.
Ariane Asimani. "My most important GCS experience is sharing over a decade of family days with friends and family. Important things I want people to know about me are that I play the guitar, I drive a Mini whose name is the Chrome Queen, and I got disqualified from the fifth grade geography B for not knowing the capital of Oklahoma." Now, my question is, do you know it now?
I think it's Oklahoma City.
You're right. Mrs. Woolihan, can we get him a prize? Yeah, good. This just goes to show you the quality of the GCS education. Now, Ariane's quote comes from his dad, Nick. What a dumb kid.
Congratulations, buddy.
Marshall Yasmin Awan. "I've been to several different schools, and none of them have given me the family that GCS has given me. I've grown a lot throughout the years, as we all have, and I couldn't be more grateful for how lucky I've been to meet some of the incredible people here and people I'll be friends with for a very long time." Marshall's quote is, "Anything that's hard is worthwhile. Hard work is good work. If you're working really hard and you feel proud of what you're doing, that's the easiest way to be happy in life." Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Nicole Therese Bachman. "My most significant experience at GCS was designing the school yearbook cover because it was a fun personal project and opportunity. It was very exciting and special to see my art on everyone's yearbook. It was also very helpful for my college art portfolio. And the ubiquitous SpongeBob quote, 'Can I be excused for the rest of my life?'" Congratulations, Nicole. Jyla C. Ba. "GCS allowed me to branch out, trying many different things in many different ways. From winning a championship for JV soccer, going to the nationals as a wrestler, and driving up and having wonderful conversations with my coaches, even learning how to play Dungeons and Dragons with the friends I've made. The conversations and experiences I've made here have truly made me a more whole and round person. Thank you, GCS." And the quote is, "There is no such thing as that rose-colored campus life." Why? Because there is nothing rose-colored in the world. Everything is a bunch of colors all mixed up. Congratulations, Jyla.
Congratulations.
Ashlyn Rose Bender. "The Washington, D.C. field trip junior year was a great experience and overall really fun. I've made amazing friends here these last 4 years. I loved playing high school basketball." The quote from Andy Bernard, "I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've left them." Congratulations, Ashlyn.
Congratulations.
I know I'm getting old when I no longer recognize most of the source of the quotes that we get. All right. Thomas Tyler Berbert. In my 13 years at GCS, I've had too many good experiences to choose just one, but I have especially enjoyed my 4 years on the baseball team. And the quote is from Derek Jeter, who will, in September, finally be inducted into the Hall of Fame. Sorry, as a Yankee fan, I have to get that in. There may be people that have more talent than you, but there's no excuse for anyone to work harder than you do. Congratulations, Tommy. Luqi Chen. My life changed at the moment my family and I decided that I would study in a foreign country. GCS is a memorable place where I first truly learned about American culture and its education. Seeing my classmates and teachers' smiling faces, I realized that the choice my family and I made, embracing American culture, is worthwhile and meaningful. Changes continue, but I will always try to step out of my comfort zone. The quote is from Shannon Alder. Life always begins with one step outside of your comfort zone. Congratulations, Jack. Hannah Grace Chipperfield. The horse shows I went to as part of the equestrian team were amazing experiences if you ignored the cold weather. The teams we met were always friendly and willing to graciously say who was the better rider. The food was universally terrible, but we always brought donuts. And the horses were, of course, the best part of the whole thing. The quote is, "A dog may be man's best friend, but the horse wrote history." Congratulations, James. Ryan Russell Chipperfield. GCS gave me the opportunity to explore a wide variety of academic subjects in enough depth that I am confidently heading to college with a roadmap. I've been interested in a few subjects, but I didn't always know what to study. Teachers recognized my interests and encouraged me to continue, always pushing me to find what makes me want to know more. I will cherish the relationships I have made at GCS. And Ryan's quote is from Pink Floyd. You set sail across the sea of long past thoughts and memories. Childhood ends, your fantasies merge with harsh realities. And then, as the sail is hoist, you find your eyes are growing moist. All the fears are never voiced. You say you have to make your final choice. Just one more brick in the wall, right, Ryan? Congratulations. Ryan S. Clemens. You know, Ryan is a man of few words, but he says, I always loved the amount of care everyone in this community showed each other. And the quote is, we didn't know we were making memories, we were just having fun. Congratulations, Ryan. Haley Isabella Clausen. I will never forget my time at GCS. In the 9 years I've been here, I've made countless memories with all of my peers, and I'm so grateful for the time we all had together. And while it was cut short, to me it was a hard lesson about the importance of living in and cherishing each and every moment. Thank you to all of my friends, family, teachers, and classmates for helping me grow and preparing me for the coming stages of my life. Haley's quotes from Dr. Martin Luther King, take the first step. You don't have to see the whole staircase, just take the first step. Congratulations, Haley. Yeah. Thank you. Congratulations. Very nice quote. Grant Weston Denny. GCS has been extremely special. When telling people what school I come from, there is always comments like, "Wow, so you have money," or "You're one of those private school snobs." When shade is thrown, I take pride in where I've spent my 4 years of school. Clearly, it wasn't the senior year we were hoping for, but the three previous years made up for it. The biggest takeaway was learning how to work under pressure and how to develop a strong work ethic. And Grant's quote is, "High school is a lot like toilet paper. You only miss it when it's gone." Congratulations, Grant.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Matthew Aiden DeVoe. I have only spent 2 years at GCS, but the impact this school has had on me is life-changing. I got very involved with athletics and community service, and these activities pushed and fully integrated me into the GCS community. This community is very close-knit, and it has been very important for me. It has helped me grow to be the very best version of myself, gain amazing relationships, and I am leaving GCS on a path towards success. Matt's quote from Winnie the Pooh, "How lucky I am to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard." Congratulations, Matt.
Thank you. Congratulations, Matt. Good job. Congratulations.
Grace Jackson Dickey. The most significant experience for me was meeting all of my wonderful friends at GCS. And now we know that popular culture has taken over because the quote is from Snooki. "The party is over. What am I going to do with my life now?" Congratulations, Grace.
Good job, Grace.
Cole Schult Fisher. I really liked how GCS gave me the opportunity to do a lot of different things while I was a student here. I got to try everything from engineering to gardening. It really gave me the chance to figure out what I wanted to do with myself and what things made me happiest. I remember my freshman year, I was in the IED program, and I wanted to play Division I soccer and be a computer science major in college. Here I am, 4 years later, playing no sports, being as far away from IED as possible, and getting ready to be a film major at college. It's just so funny how, looking back at myself freshman year, I just can't help but think, thank goodness I'm still not doing that. The quote is from Chris Farley, "I don't know what the future holds. All I know is I'm good today, real good." Congratulations, Cole.
Buddy.
Dylan Douglas George. I enjoyed reading history packets and sparring with teammates in history club with Mr. Prophet, discussing the meeting of family with Mrs. Ding, and suffering through cross country and track with Coach Bond. And this quote makes me happy because I know that Seinfeld will never die. Dylan's quote is, "I declare this the summer of George." From George Costanza. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Caroline Elizabeth Haynes. I am beyond grateful that freshman year my friends accepted me to GCS. After moving several times in my life, GCS is a place where I truly feel at home. I could not have done it without the enduring support from my friends, family, coaches, and teachers. I will certainly miss basketball game days, AP Euro, lunches on the sidewalk, and the AP Lit Myself on Fire group chat. Congratulations, class of 21. And the quote happens to be from my favorite Stoic, Marcus Aurelius, "Nothing happens to any man that he isn't formed by nature to endure." Congratulations, Caroline.
Well done.
Yeah. Daniel Thomas Hersey. My favorite memories at GCS are going to the championship in lacrosse in my junior year and being able to spend time with my friends every day at school. My favorite memory is working with Daniel on his integrative paper, every week via Zoom, every Wednesday. You really did a good job on that, Dan. And the quote is from Muhammad Ali, "If your dreams don't scare you, they aren't big enough." I hope to see you flying someday, Dan. Congratulations. Brianna McKenzie Hibbert. My time at GCS has provided me with numerous memorable experiences, from wandering alone throughout DC to getting lost on the streets of New York. While I do not miss the late night study sessions and last minute papers, I swear I'll work on my procrastination in college. I am so thankful to have gone through these experiences with some of my best friends. The quote is from Vice President Kamala Harris. "We did it. We did it, Joe." Ha, ha, ha. Congratulations, Brianna.
I got it. Thanks. Yeah.
McKenna Kukukakalani Hillman. Out of so many individual moments and experiences at GCS, both big and small, some of the best memories come from the moments of passing conversations in the hallways between classes, or a few minutes of cramming before a test with classmates, a few minutes of downtime backstage during Guys and Dolls dancing with the cast, a meaningful conversation in GSA. Those moments of interaction almost always helped on a bad day. The quote is from Caduceus Clay, "I could write a book about the things I don't know." Congratulations, McKenna.
I tried my best.
Jacob William Hopkins Luna. An important memory for me is talking to Mr. Land after class about the infinite value of our lives. I'm ready to move forward. This next era of me will be one for the books. Good luck to everyone. And the quote is from Badula Oblongata. Peace and blessings manifest with every lesson learned. If your knowledge were your wealth, then it would be well earned. Congratulations, Jacob. Madison Lynn Howard. I've made a lot of memories here at GCS, ones that I will never forget. Thanks to all the teachers, and most importantly, love to you and Dad, love to Mom and Dad. Can't wait for next year. Go Tigers. The quote from Florence Welch, "In every one of us shines the light of love." Congratulations, Madison.
Congratulations.
Shujiao Wo. When I arrived at GCS 4 years ago, I was full of energy to explore. Throughout high school, I've been lucky enough to have Mr. and Mrs. Garvey providing me with a welcoming home to live in. And I have many friends and teachers who bestow love and compassion upon me in stressful and overwhelming situations. Mr. Hudgens inspired me to take my own initiative in research, and Mrs. Hack made me fall in love with chemistry. The quote is, "Do what makes you happy. Be with who makes you smile. Love as much as you breathe, and love as long as you live." Congratulations, Stella.
Congratulations, Stella.
Macy Elizabeth Jackson. I am glad to have grown and changed at GCS, as well as watching the people around me grow and change. Each year at GCS has been an era, and I am glad to have made my 9 years' worth of memories with you all. The quote from Franklin Roosevelt, "The only thing we have to fear is fear itself." Congratulations, Macy. Erin Elizabeth Jacobs. The last 14 years at GCS have provided me with some of the greatest friends, memories, and lessons I could ever have asked for. They shaped me into the person I am today, and I am beyond thankful to everyone, especially my teachers and family, for being by my side through it all. Above all else, I am most grateful for Espresso, Taylor Swift's music, AP European History memes for getting me through the hardest days. And of course, the quote is from Taylor Swift, "Long live all the magic we made, bring on all the pretenders, one day we will be remembered." Congratulations, Erin. Damon Kathoria. I am a motivated student who has demonstrated a strong work ethic and creative abilities and have GCS to thank for a lot of that. I was really proud to have represented GCS in the Maryland Math League, for being inducted into the National Honor Society and the National Society of High School Scholars. For me, GCS has been an extension of my family. The friendships I have made here will be cherished throughout my life. The bond, the knowledge shared with my teachers is unbreakable. Through my learning here, I developed a strong interest in information technology, and I am now looking to pursue a career in cybersecurity and artificial intelligence. Damon's quote is from Juice WRLD, "Everybody stay positive, no matter how negative life gets." Congratulations, Damon.
Congratulations, Damon.
Well done.
Congratulations,
Damon. Keita Kobayashi. Throughout the past 7 years I've spent at GCS, I've been able to learn and grow both as a student and as an individual. As a member of the community, I have had the pleasure of surrounding myself with many amazing people. My high school experience certainly did not end the way I expected, but I have no doubts that I will cherish the time that I did spend as a student at GCS. And the quote is from J.R.R. Tolkien. "There are no safe paths in this part of the world. Remember, you are over the edge of the wild now, and for all sorts of fun wherever you go." Congratulations, Keita.
Congratulations.
Anna Gardenia Lucas. My favorite memory at GCS was the eighth grade field trip to Williamsburg. It was a wonderful opportunity to bond with my classmates while enjoying the historic area and having fun in Busch Gardens. We were all excited about the next phase of our GCS experience in upper school, and it was nice to have that special time together. Her quote is a special quote from Thurgood Marshall. It's about his reflections on the petitioners of Briggs versus Elliott and Brown versus the Board of Education, which happened to include her grandmother, Dina Stokes Hightower, her brothers and parents. So the quote from Thurgood Marshall, "In recognizing the humanity of our fellow human beings, we pay ourselves the highest tribute." Congratulations, Anna. Nawab Mahmood. Transferring to GCS in the sixth grade, I was a young and shy kid who always cared a lot about what other people thought of me. But throughout my freshman year, I was really able to grow out of my shell and become more confident with myself. This was thanks to my many friends and classmates, the GCS basketball team, and my teachers. Now, thanks to GCS, I'm ready to take on any challenges that lie ahead of me. The quote is from Kobe Bryant, "The biggest mistake we make in life is thinking we have time." Wow. Thanks, Nawab.
Congratulations.
Michael Connor Malone. Connor says he is very grateful for all the people around him, and his quote is, "Anything in life worth doing is worth overdoing." Congratulations, Connor.
Congratulations.
Olivia Maeve Marks. The service trip to New Orleans I participated in during my sophomore year was not only fun, but also rewarding. While volunteering for the St. Bernard Project with my classmates, I had the opportunity to serve the community affected by Hurricane Katrina, experience New Orleans culture, and form strong bonds with my peers. I'm extremely grateful for all of the wonderful people I have met and the experiences I've had at Glen Elg Country School. The quote is from Maya Angelou, "And still, I rise." Congratulations, Olivia. David Mark Miller. My teachers have been great and willing to help me when I needed it. Next year, I'm going to Penn State York to play baseball. I would like to thank my parents for giving me the opportunity to attend GCS this year and making my goal of playing college baseball possible. The quote is from Daryl Philbin from The Office, right? Ready for this one? Bippity boppity, give me the zoppity. Congratulations, David.
Hey, everybody. Congratulations.
Now, as we shift sides, I will take a drink. Ready, Seth? Yeah. Seth Riley Miller. Being involved in the different sports programs with my friends and classmates was the most significant and important experience of my high school career. The quote is from Ricky Bobby. If you ain't first, where are you, Seth? You're not, but if you're not first, in his head, if you're not first, you're last. Congratulations, Seth. Buddy, thanks. Olivia Riley Milne. I can't imagine what my life would have been like had I not chosen to come to GCS 4 years ago. It's been here that I've met my best friends, achieved more than I ever thought possible, and become the best version of myself. I'll never forget the New Orleans service trip, dancing around the mullets, picnic lunches on the sidewalk, and driving Miss Weber absolutely insane in AP Lit. Congratulations, everyone. The quote from Jane Austen, finally a classic. Perhaps it is our imperfections that make us perfect. Congratulations, Olivia.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Catherine Jane Morningstar. Having grown up here, it is easy for me to call GCS home. I am so grateful for all the memories I've made throughout the past 13 years. I will cherish all of the friendships I have made, as well as all of the relationships I have built with my teachers. While I will miss GCS, I am excited for the next chapter in my life. The quote from Maya Angelou, "Nothing can dim the light that shines from within." Congratulations, Kat. Stella Bruno Moynihan. I've gone to GCS my whole life, and spending 13 years with the same people is quite the experience. Thank you for all the laughs, the trip to DC, all the other crazy moments that I don't have room to list. Shout out to the AP Lit Myself on Fire group and all the other group chats that got us through. Thank you for everything. We did it. The quote from Winnie the Pooh from Eeyore, "It never hurts to keep looking for sunshine." Congratulations, Stella. Daniel James Myrick. My experiences at GCS cannot be described in a single event, but rather a multitude of experiences that helped change who I was over the course of 4 years. Whether it be engaging in conversations at lunch that helped broaden my perspective, change my views, or pushing me out of my comfort zone to starting my club. All of these experiences helped change me for the better, and I'm grateful for my 4 years at GCS. The quote is from Ralph Waldo Emerson. I'm glad he still makes the list. What lies behind us and what lies before us are small matters compared to what lies within us. Congratulations, Dan. Sydney Conchetta Rose Naylor. One of my best memories at GCS was always the bus rides to and from field hockey and lacrosse games. It was when people would put their phones down, sing their hearts out, and connect with each other. My best memories were always the bus rides with my teammates. And this is one of my all-time favorite quotes. It's from The Godfather. Leave the gun, take the cannoli. Congratulations, Sydney. Briti Puran Nibnani. GCS is where I've called home for the last 6 years, and it's the place where I grew. I would like to thank my parents, my friends, and all of my teachers, especially my advisors, Mr. Schmidt and Mr. Shovlin. The most valuable experience I gained from GCS was the opportunity to learn a multitude of languages. Not only do I speak English and Hindi, but I now speak Spanish, Thai, and I am learning French. The quote is from Sun Tzu. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Congratulations, Briti. Cecilia Joan Nilsson. When my school closed last year, I was ready to just put my head down and push through a pretty bad senior year. But my time at Glen Elk has really been good, and I am so grateful for the people that welcomed me into the community and made this a great senior year, even though it was so totally odd. Special thanks to Mr. Coffle, Mr. Macaluso, and Mr. Neblett. The quote from Mary Oliver, "What is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life?" Congratulations, Cecilia.
Congratulations. Good luck. Good luck.
Cecilia. Esther Marie Alice Nissen. I've loved my GCS experience, from wandering around DC to tennis matches to lunches with my friends. Since kindergarten, GCS has given me amazing memories, like Scooter World, the eighth grade Williamsburg trip, late night study FaceTime calls with my friends. While I won't miss turning in my papers 5 minutes before the deadline or studying the night before for a test, I am grateful to my friends, teachers, and my family for the support they've given me. The quote from Smash Mouth, "Only shooting stars break the mold." Congratulations, Esther.
Congratulations.
Good night.
Cole Morgan Gwynn Parr. The most significant experience I had at GCS was my 4 years as a member of the varsity basketball team. The countless practices, workouts, and lifts truly taught me the meaning of hard work. and the lessons I was taught in the GCS gym and the memories I made with my teammates will stay with me for the rest of my life. The quote from Joel Embiid, trust the process. Congratulations, Cole.
Bud.
Cecilia Elizabeth Pell. My favorite memories at GCS are getting to play sports with my friends, like lacrosse, soccer, and basketball. I loved playing volleyball outside during free periods, class cup challenges in the forum, and finally Mr. Conroy's ancient studies class freshman year. The quote is from Shikamaru Nara, "Laziness is the mother of all bad habits, but ultimately she is a mother and we should respect her." Congratulations, Cecilia. Dylan Xavier Ravenel. GCS has shown me that doors and opportunities can be open to anyone who decides and wants to put the work in. Attending GCS has also made me appreciate philanthropy and, in general, giving back to my community. And the quote, do you want to say this yourself? Uh-huh. Go ahead.
Dylan Ravenel for president, 2040.
Congratulations, Dylan. Caroline Kelly Rader. My favorite memory is my sophomore year. Our lacrosse team beat our rival St. Paul's School for Girls in overtime, and we dogpiled on the field. SpongeBob SquarePants memorably said, "You will never know the true value of a moment until it becomes a memory." Congratulations, Caroline.
Well done.
Margaret Leah Resch. My most significant experience at GCS was that I've had, I'm sorry, one of the most significant experiences I've had at GCS is watching for the daffodils on the side of the road on campus to start blooming. Seeing them finally bloom each year reminds me of the time that had passed and the time that I have ahead of me. The quote is from Fred Hoyle, "Space isn't really remote at all. In fact, it's only an hour's drive away if your car could go straight upwards." Congratulations, Trixie.
Congratulations.
Ryan Joseph Russo. A significant experience that I had at GCS was when I broke my collarbone freshman year on the Seven Springs ski trip. It was the last time down the mountain, and my friends and I didn't want to get hurt because we were excited for our freshman year of lacrosse. As painful 4-hour bus ride home, and my dad and I watched Super Bowl 52 in the ER that night. This anonymous quote, is it really anonymous? I don't know. "I spent 113,880 hours of my life for a paper and a handshake." But we did put that piece of paper in a nice cover for you, Ryan.
There you go.
Rohit Saha. The 6 years I've spent at GCS have been some of the best of my life. They've been filled with experiences that I'll continue to cherish for the rest of my life. I'd like to thank everyone who made the last few years of my life so special. I wish them luck in their future endeavors. The quote is from Osamu Dazai. This I want to believe implicitly. Man was born for love and revolution. Congratulations, Rohit. Alyssa Ann Song. My most important experience at GCS was when I went on freshman expeditions. I came to GCS as a freshman, and I didn't know anyone in my class. On that trip, I was able to make connections with people who are now my best friends today. Miley Cyrus wrote, "Life's a climb, but the view is great." Congratulations, Alyssa. Richard Thomas Seipel. When people ask me if I like GCS, I always tell them, well, I hated going to school until I started going to GCS. This community has changed me, and I'll be forever thankful for that. I've made lifelong friends here, and I cannot wait to see what great things we will achieve in the next chapter of our lives. The quote is from Walter Mattson. If you don't know, Walter Mattson is a faculty member here, and apparently Mr. Mattson once said, well, it's not a rom-com, it's more like a rom-com. Congratulations, Richie. Milan Tharmesh Shah. I really enjoyed our advisory barbecues with Mr. Shovlin, Mr. Schmidt, and other students. The quote is from Grant Cardone. Don't just make money, make a difference. Congratulations, Milan. Well done. Lipeng Sheng. A most significant or important experience at GCS, a few important things I wanted people to know about as I graduate, was my experience with the robotics team and my favorite elective, AP Computer Science. The quote, our dream will always come true if we work hard. Congratulations, Samuel.
Congratulations.
Abhijit Singh. AJ says, my most significant experience at GCS was my freshman year. I was able to gather up to 20 demerits, and I served 2 detentions. After that year, I realized that the time of being in middle school and being a kid was up, and it helped me realize that it is time to grow up and start taking some responsibility. I would like to thank all the teachers who gave me those demerits because they have helped me become a much better student than I was back then. His quote is from Naruto Uzumaki. If you don't like your destiny, don't accept it. Instead, have the courage to change it the way you want it to be. Congratulations, AJ. Imros Baldev Singh. Throughout all my years at GCS, I have always loved Family Day, since it is the time for GCS community to celebrate what it means to be together. I always loved the Haunted Trail, and I had the remarkable experience to help lay out the plans and build it 2 years ago. This quote is anonymous. Literally no one knows what they're doing out there. We'll be okay. Congratulations, Imros. Noor Baldev Singh. I distinctly remember eating watermelon slices bigger than my face in Ms. Miller's pre-first classroom. And just last month, I defended my integrative research paper about the ethics of human genome editing and the human enhancement. Wow, what a swing, huh? Yeah. The quote is from Robin Williams. No matter what people tell you, words and ideas can change the world. Congratulations, Noor. Bennett Evan Smith. One important thing, not necessarily an experience, was being able to create various projects and creations in the STEM courses in the upper school. They taught me how to use various tools and softwares, helped to steer me into pursuing a more engineering-centered outlook for my future. The quote from John Mulaney, "It's 100% easier not to do things than to do them." Congratulations, Ben.
Well done, Ben.
Yep.
Dylan Gray Sterry. It's not one specific memory, but remember all the after-school talks in the forum? It was generally with classmates that I never interacted with regularly. We always had the funniest conversations. These moments were where I felt closest to the GCS community. The quote is from Monkey D. Luffy. "No matter how hard or impossible it is, never lose sight of your goal." Congratulations, Dylan. Hung Yi's son. "I really appreciate all my friends and teachers at GCS. Each of them has left a brush of paint for me, so my high school life became colorful because of them." And Henry's quote is, "Never forget the original intention. Continue to strive to pursue that goal." Congratulations, Henry.
Well done.
Brian Teske. "My most important experience here at GCS was leading the 2019-2020 varsity ice hockey team to their first playoff berth in school history, in addition to receiving all-conference recognition for the season. Graduating from GCS has taught me many valuable life lessons, and I would like to thank my family, my friends, and teachers for all that they have done for me." The quote is from Dr. Seuss, "Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened." Congratulations, Brian. Brian,
congratulations.
Bowen Tian. "I don't think I can adequately express myself in this short a space, so I won't even try. I'll just say thank you for the 4 years, especially to our dedicated teachers and other faculty members. Until next time." The quote is from Christopher Nolan in The Prestige. "Now you're looking for the secret, but you won't find it, because of course, you're not really looking. You don't really want to work it out. We want to be fooled." Congratulations, Owen. Hannah Tujar. "Starting GCS as a freshman, I had no idea the impact the school would have on my life. It was here that I realized my passion for languages and science. Each teacher truly focused on me as an individual and pushed me to become the best version of myself. I've made many amazing friends these past few years and created memories that I will carry with me for the rest of my life." The quote from Kerry Washington, "Your life is your story, and the adventure ahead of you is the journey to fulfill your own purpose and potential." Congratulations, Hannah. Mitchell Dennis Turner. "I think back on how my friends and the community welcomed me back to GCS so well and easily after I returned. I was here during preschool and lower school, but then I happened to move away, and I was upset that I might lose so many close friends. Thankfully, they all remembered me when I came back to the high school, and I will forever cherish the memories we made. Thank you, Glenelg Country School." And Mitchell's quote is, "Are you coming to my house? Or are you coming to my house? Is that better? How do you want to say it?
Are you coming to my house?
There you go. All right. Congratulations, Mitchell. Sofia Estefania Vallejo. I started here when I was 3 years old, giving me many memories to look back on at GCS. I will never forget running down the hill with my friends behind the lower school castle, the eighth grade Williamsburg trip, and the Spanish exchange. I want to shout out and thank my mom, Senora Vallejo. She has helped me with so many assignments and important decisions in my life, so thank her for everything. The quote from Maya Angelou, "Success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it." Congratulations, Sophia.
Congratulations.
Emma Frisky Vanderlind. An important experience at GCS was participating in the musicals. I enjoyed teaching choreography and eventually winning a Cappy with my classmates. The quote is from Bernard Baruch. "Be who you are, say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind." Congratulations, Emma. Ava Christine Vanek. My sophomore year, I went on the school ski trip thinking it would be a great idea to learn how to snowboard. That didn't go very well, so I switched to learning how to ski. And the classmates I was skiing with wanted to go down a black diamond. I totally crashed, and after about 20 minutes, my classmates were still at the bottom waiting for me. The best thing about GCS is that students and teachers support each other unconditionally, and I am so grateful to have experienced that support throughout my high school career. Peter Pan said, "To live would be an awfully big adventure." Congratulations, Ava. Yes. Kristen Neha Verma. I've learned a lot and experienced so much during my time at GCS. The people I met, the opportunities I had, they all helped me become who I am. I realized my passion for books and my love for field hockey. I'm proud of everything I've learned from both these things, and I'm proud of who I am now. The quote from Will Herondale, "Life is a book, and there are 1,000 pages I have not yet read." Congratulations, Kristen.
Congratulations.
Austin James Williams. I feel like in each year of my GCS experience, I grew as a person and as a part of the community. Being involved in the basketball program all 3 years took up most of my time, but it created memories I will never forget. The quote is from Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know that the thoughts I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." Congratulations, Austin. Now, our next student, I hope, is tuning in from China, Yiqing Yan. My team designed a special slot machine and built it ourselves for Cedar Lane School in IED class. I joined the school all-girls robotic team as a coding leader. I dedicated myself to the idea of women in STEAM by hosting STEAM events in China to promote more girls to participate in the science area. Karina's quote is, "Nothing is impossible. The world itself says, I'm possible." That's from Audrey Hepburn. Congratulations, Karina. I hope you're watching. Juliet Esra Yolte. First and foremost, it was my honor to serve as class president. I will forever cherish the memories of serving and representing this class. Personally, I will miss the late night study sessions, intense tennis matches, most importantly, my best friends. This all wouldn't have been possible without my parents, so thank you to my lovely parents for always supporting me and being my number one fan. The quote is from Khalil Gibran. Out of suffering have emerged the strongest souls. The most massive characters are seared with scars. Congratulations, Juliet.
Congratulations.
Well, so, our final student is also tuning in from China, and that's Tianxi Zhang. I'll read Emma's quotes. As the only international student in the choir, I did not feel lonely. Winter concerts make me feel like we are close friends with each other, not just singing together. Even though I wasn't able to see them again in my senior year, I'm very happy that I spent my only 2 years in GCS with the choir. And Emma's quote is, it is not our abilities that show what we truly are, it is our choices. I hope you're watching, Emma. Congratulations.
So I have one last diploma to present. It's for Gregory J. Ventry. As most of you know, Greg will be retiring from GCS as our head of school effective June 30th. He started in July of 2007 and has led us through many ups and downs for these 14 years of service to GCS. I am honoring his specific request that the school not make a big deal of his departure, as we sat in his kitchen in July. But if you could please join me in giving Greg the send-off he deserves with a dragon round of applause as a small token of our appreciation for him. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you. This means more to me than anything. So now I have to get through my brief remarks. I'll take another swig of water. FYI, before I officially present the class, I hope you'll indulge me with a few final remarks. And at the end, the three wise men up on the stage will proceed down the middle aisle. The seniors will follow us. The faculty will line the hallway to form a receiving line. We can all go back into the forum and the cafeteria and maybe outside, depending. Take a look at the alumni wall, take a look at the senior gift, spend some time together. I have some thank yous for making this event very possible. Mary Ellen Prantl, Brandon Neblett, our all-star operations team, our faculty, everyone who worked hard. I do have one final presentation also to make, and because Mary Ellen did not earn 20 years to get an honorary diploma, does not mean that we should not recognize what she has meant to us. So Mary Ellen, why don't you come on up here for a second? As I said, not quite accumulating the years to qualify for a diploma, for her 16 years of care and support for the Upper School family, thank you so much. All right, some brief remarks. Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations. Your education here is complete. The rest of your education is just beginning. I approach this graduation with a special sense of joy for this class, but also with a deep feeling of melancholy for many different reasons. As if fighting COVID-19 was not challenging enough, we are still fighting in our nation a against each other. Once again, we suffer from the scourges of systemic violence and the polarization in our society on so many levels. It's like a loud noise in the background that never seems to go away. Speaking of loud noises, like the cicadas who have joined our party and entered our lives, you too have waited 17 years to come to this moment. You guys were born essentially around the same time as our insect friends. Perhaps you can find kinship with them. Like them, we slowly crawled out of our holes, eyes blinking, taking tentative steps towards reconnecting with our lives and purposes. Now you too are officially shedding your GCS shells, finding a new, full-throated voice, just as they are. But you have been trained to do this, to find your voices. It is in your nature, just as it is in the brood X's nature. Happily, however, your prospects for the future are much brighter than our insect friends. Perhaps, however, when their progeny emerges, and by the way, you will then be 34 years old, you might think back to this day, to all we've been through, and remember that you also commenced then, emerged back into the light. And whatever you are doing in the year 2038, maybe you will take a moment to reflect on the incredible things that happened in your commencement year. We spent a challenging last few years together, facing loss and adversity and trying to look ahead. This class has led us in that endeavor, and in many ways, that may be their biggest achievement. To have stepped up to bring a sense of normalcy to an aberrant situation, a sense of joy to difficult times, and emotional maturity large enough to support those in need, and an appreciation of one another in their school that transcended the difficulties of the moment. If that were your only achievement, you would be remembered as a special class. But of course, as you have heard and read in your programs, that is by far not the only achievement of this class. Your academic, athletic, artistic, community service, and leadership success is a matter of record. Your live GCS experience was unplugged in the spring of 2020 and essentially remained so as our year began. As we gradually reopened, your joy returned. Things that we take for granted, being here on campus, the touchstones that center us, the games, the concerts, the celebrations started to happen. As they did, I think we all reawakened to what really shapes our experience at GCS. We had become disconnected from our core, unbalanced, forced to adjust to new modes of learning and communicating, all the while trying to take care of our family's health and safety. Words such as unprecedented have been overused, but certainly remain apt to describe our situation. It's over a century since the world has experienced such a cataclysmic health crisis. Furthermore, we cannot say for sure what the future holds. Uncertainty is the order of the day. And while I can remind you that this is not your life, only a part of your life, it is unquestionably a time etched in your hearts and embedded in your memories. Yet things are getting better. As evidence, here we are today, together, trying to recreate some semblance of normalcy, some form of an event we have been looking forward to for some time. We adapted, we revised, and we still need in some very visceral way to come together in whatever way we can to celebrate this milestone in the lives of this class and their families, whom we deeply care about and appreciate. Maybe we wondered, will we ever be the same? Will we ever reconnect? Will we be afraid to embrace each other? Is it possible that intimacy, which is the purest form of humanity, will be forever altered? You have already belied those notions and shown that is not the case. As graduates of GCS, I implore you to transcend those fears and rise along with the better angels of our shared nature, to be influencers in recreating the best of who we are and want to be. Back to the notion of finding your voice. Ever since the 12th century, the beautiful muted swans in England have been deemed royal property. During Victorian times, every spring, wranglers — swans are not generally cooperative and not easy to catch — and so wranglers were sent out to gather the swans for the royal table. Before they became a culinary delicacy, these muted swans apparently, like our cicada friends, found their voices, singing their final songs, indeed, their swan songs. 2021, this is our GCS swan song. As you go on from here today, I ask you to remember your dragon heritage. Must be water somewhere. Remember your dragon heritage and carry those values with you, especially your sense of honor and justice, your big hearts, traits desperately needed in the world today. I know that this family will always be there for you, and remember, you're always dragons. Finally, I'm sorry. Finally, my most sincere thanks to all of you for the support, kindness, and care over these 14 years. I wish you all the very best, and I will, as I hope you will also be, always ready to stand up for GCS. So, seniors, graduates, please stand up. I ask you to turn your tassels, and please join me in saluting the class of 2021. Thank you, Francis. We're ready.